Building Kids' Lives in Our Community on BCTV is supported by UPMC for You.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks so much for tuning in to Building Kids Lives. I'm Jill Troutman, your host. And today we have a wonderful opportunity to talk about something that I love, which is a career. And maybe you love it too. You've had a career for a long time, or maybe you're just starting your journey. But that's really what we're going to be talking about today. And that is a casting call for career opportunities at the children's home. So we're looking for all those wonderful people. So today I have Irving Gonzalez. Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having me.
And Irving is so special. We just hired Irving a little while ago to start working with the Children's Home of Reading, specifically and the CHOR Youth and Family Services Division of our programs. So Irving is our recruitment specialist, and he's the man behind the phone number that you're gonna see plastered all over, the new tablecloth that we have here. You're gonna be seeing him out and about. He'll be the face behind the table, and he's gonna be the one that will be your first point of contact at the Children's Home of Reading.
That's a lot of pressure.
I know, that's a lot of pressure. Irving, you can handle it.
I don't know, but I do appreciate the little tag that you said about casting call, because you know, I do have a theater background, so you're speaking my language.
I love that. And really, that is kind of what it's like when you post a job, whether it's on Facebook, on Indeed,
right,
LinkedIn, on a flyer, it is a kind of like a casting call, isn't it?
It is. And you know what's so nice about this new kind of transition that we are now kind of spearheading is that oftentimes you will just get me over the phone, we're talking, but there's no face-to-face. So I'm so thrilled that now that we have our ideal spot, that individuals can come in and have that one-on-one face-to-face, because it really makes it more personal versus having to be kind of a robotic, kind of scripted conversation.
Yeah, and you know, I bet you see a lot of different kinds of people, don't you?
Well, I've learned to be flexible. I've learned to improv. I've learned to kind of really listen and have those dialogues that you may think you're going to go in this direction, but you find out that wow, we're heading into this direction, and having that open dialogue and being flexible, it just promotes a personal investment and one-on-one touch on that individual.
I really like that. I wish everybody would be like that when you go looking for a job. Not that I'm looking for one yet, I guess.
Well, call me. Yeah. We do have internal applications that you are more than happy to apply for.
That is very true, too. So let's talk about you are starting this new career center, which is something we have never had at the Children's Home of Reading, which has been there for, gosh, almost 140 years now.
Right, and I think that was kind of a vision in terms of where do we see ourselves? I know I was here, less than a year ago with my co-partner, Steve, and I think it was about realizing that We needed to have something on site that wasn't just about trying to hire people, but really having that collaboration among the other departments, really getting an idea of what their visions are. And for us as recruiters, it's always great to be educated in their departments. Oh, yeah. How am I going to recruit if I don't know anything about your department? I don't want to get this pigeonhole cookie cutter of an individual. I want to be able to have that early dialogue and kind of tailor the ideal individual that you're looking for.
Right, and I think that's so important that we do get the right people to do these human service jobs. They're tough jobs. They're not easy jobs, whether you are the cook, the cleaner, the YBS worker, whether you're a member of the leadership team or, you know, a caseworker or clinical therapist or anything like that. That job is a really demanding job when you're in human services. And there is such a gap in human services. There's a 38% turnover in many of the places, according to RCPA, which is the Residential Care Providers Association. That came out yesterday, and there is a 28% vacancy. So, number one, we're working really hard as the organization with emptiness to begin with. Already, somewhere, you know, I don't know what our numbers are, but 28% under people who are like in organizations that are in the human services.
And, you know,
that's really hard.
It is hard to kind of grasp when you think about it. But I would say this, that yesterday I was, well, we were engaged in the job fair that was kind of hosted by the city of Reading's mayor, as well as Congressman Guzman, who there were so many vendors there, so many affiliates, so many job seekers and individuals that are looking, that I was amazed of the resources and the availability of what's out there. Now it's about how do we get our information out there? Mm-hmm. And that's where you come in as their VP of branding and marketing, the other, you know, kind of department heads to really collectively have a vision and a mission and say, we need to get those vacancies, you know, filled. And how do we do that?
Yeah, and I think, it's, you know, that's something that we talk about, the leadership team.
Right.
How are we going to support each other?
Right.
You know, and when there are gaps, how do we fit in? I will sometimes work, you know, a different position just because one of our team can't make it.
Right.
They're sick. Or to give somebody who has done a lot of overtime or might be having a crisis in their family, able to help out. And I think that that's something that we are always looking for, those kinds of candidates who have that wanting to give back as well as get a paycheck.
Right. And you know, it's interesting you say that, because if you take away the titles, if you take away the departments, who's left? It's the individuals we serve. And ultimately, that is our goal, is how do we continue to provide those services without interrupting their day-to-day lives and being somehow...
And having the consistency, which is what our kids in all of our programs or families are looking for. They're looking to be able to depend on the Children's Home of Reading. And if the Children's Home of Reading goes away, that's 3,300 people and their families that are not being served every year.
You're absolutely
that's
right.
That's a lot. 45 programs. So we offer a huge opportunity for people just here in Reading, Lehigh Valley, Doylestown, you know, in the surrounding counties.
Right.
We're very excited about that. And I think, you know, college kids are a great pool for us right now. And I think the college graduates, listen up. We want to see you, right?
Yeah. You know, you say that because, you know, I want to make sure that, you know, it's such a pilot program, but there's so many key components, so many key players that are really intricate in making it successful. It really, like you said, that first impression, it begins with as soon as call, or as soon as they, you know, park, or as soon as they go to a security office and see Raina, you know, that is...
Or that email
Facebook
at 3 or 4 in the morning. We're not responding to that, everybody. We will respond to you in the next day, right?
But again, it's those key components that somebody's interested in me. Somebody sees a potential that perhaps I don't see. And, you know, you talk about the college students, and we just hired someone yesterday that I'm so excited to kind of bring into the CHOR family, because you know, we have that curriculum of, you know, many opportunities that an individual can start as a youth care worker, but then work their way in perhaps a case manager or so I'm excited because that's a component that I had no idea. You know, you look
at the career ladder that I love.
Yeah.
Career ladder. So we have 45 programs across what we call CHOR Youth and Family Services,
right,
which is all of our programs. So we have 45 different programs going on at any given time, every day, I should say, not any given time, but every day. And then from that, they can go in between these, but then because of how we are aligned with and part of the Imperium Constellation, there are 35 other companies that are similar to CHOR in some way, mm-hmm, shape, or form, whether it's IDD work, intellectual disabilities, for those of you who don't know. CHOR, like a children's youth and family services, there might be a drug and alcohol treatment, but there's also ways so that if people start with us, they can move up within that, all across that constellation, and be able to go to Texas because we have somebody down there, mm-hmm, Tennessee, or you know, Connecticut,
or even Colorado.
Colorado. Colorado.
I love
and we
that
all
place.
Want to go to Colorado. We all want to go there. But really, this is, you know, but I think it also starts with you, Irv,
right,
and Dee,
yes,
having that passion. And I think you guys came up with some kind of goals, maybe mission of your career center?
Yeah, you know, I would say prior to us being on site, again, like I said, that it was just working from home or working remotely. But then somehow, you know, it lost this kind of spark. Somewhere during that whole transition, we realized there's something missing here. So thankfully, the leadership and the, you know, those part of this transition decided, why can't we just have it on site? So this is kind of like almost like a blueprint or a template of what's soon to come. So Dee and I, who will probably do answer those emails at 3 o'clock or
yes,
4 o'clock in the morning. So
I gave her access, so I don't have to watch.
There
it
you
now.
Go. So I think learning to one, create a new culture, because that's we're coming in, mm-hmm, to this CHOR umbrella of family with, of course, you know, different departments and different personalities. And it's like, okay, how do we work together? Let's create kind of almost like a vision or at least a starting goal. And that was, I call it like the three C's, which is collaboration, community outreach, and connection. So.
Okay, so C3, I like this.
Yeah,
C3.
C3.
You have that. You know, and all of those things are so part of what you do at the Career Center. So there's five more seats, so we can really go down. But, you know, that connection is so important.
It is.
And all those things you said, so say them again for
us. So that was collaboration, meaning bridging the gap between program recruitment. You know, hearing from them, what is your ideal candidate? Who do you want to see in this position? Community outreach. Again, we have several job fairs coming up. We have one coming up with the Morning Call. We have one with the PA Career Link. And if you want more information, of course, go to their website or go to our website, which is buildingkidslives.org.
Yes. So I love that to know that already. Thank
well,
you.
Well, I remember the last time we had to write it down, but I'm like, you know what? I have to come prepared. But, you know, and then, of course, connection. You know, we're so thankful that we have the resources to bring in a potential candidate. They can apply on the spot, be interviewed, and then begin their onboarding process. So it's like a one-stop kind of a quick shop, but for your start of your career path. And
right,
again, these are all just, you know, things that we're going to learn in terms of what works, what doesn't work. But that collaboration with you, with the other departments,
right,
we're going to be so above, or I should say more ahead. And one of the things is that having them be engaged in actually the on-site, the programs, like our YBS coordinators, having them actually meet the candidates,
right,
and having them to really, you know, we just do kind of like the pre-screen, but it's different now that they're on the site.
You can take them over and show them,
yeah,
the residential. You can take them upstairs to foster care or out to Barb at, you know, with her,
yes,
nurse family partnership.
Yes.
Be able to do that and really get to see firsthand. The candidates are getting an inside view that not everybody gets to see.
And what a what a privilege to have that, because it's different when you speak to someone on the phone and you're like, because you're only basing on what you hear and what you see on paper.
Right.
But having them on site, having that dialogue, it tells a lot about, is this person going to be impactful to these students or to these individuals' lives?
Right, and are we going to contribute to theirs as well?
Yeah, exactly,
That is, you know, that is also a big part of it. And I think, you know, I just saw some people, I met them this morning, they were coming down the stairs from training, so they've already had the little preview, but it was nice. And, you know, one of the things the one young woman who's a YBS said was, I don't know how to introduce Jill because she also comes over and works with the kids. And I think that that, you know, is so funny. I said, I just work here, but I'm here to help connect everybody. And really, I'm so glad you're here.
Mm.
I thought, you know what? I wish somebody would have said that to me my first day. I'm
right.
So glad you're here.
Yeah.
And I think that that is the philosophy of most of our staff. You know, when they meet somebody new, we want you to be part of the team. We want you to be successful, and we're here to help you with that.
Right.
You
I
know,
mean,
if
you,
you're willing
you,
to do that.
You came up with a great, I guess, tagline, we're better together.
Yeah.
And I'm learning as I'm on site, meeting the new potential new hires, working with my fellow peers. I'm learning a lot about what that really means, and it's allowing me to kind of maybe perhaps adjust some of my recruitment skills, tools, assessment, you know, perspective. So I love that.
Yeah, me too. And I love the fact that they're getting that firsthand experience before they even, you know, they're getting to see what it entails.
Right.
Talk to the supervisors, talk to you,
mm-hmm.
you know, and get that firsthand look. I love that we're doing that. And we could not have done that without you being here. But to say that, we're going to be having some open houses, right?
We are. We are working through some of the specifics. But all I can say is that, may I give them my number?
Oh, everybody take this down. Listen really close.
So let's just say you're in the neighborhood and feel like, let me just drop by CHOR, which is located on 1010 Center Avenue in Reading. And so my phone number is 610-478-8266, extension 487. Let's have a dialogue. And of course, we have our website, you know, buildingkidslives.org. What's great about that is now you can actually go online, see the job descriptions, requirements, and start your application right there.
Your process right there.
Yeah.
I know. It's kind of scary that we're actually moving to that. It's amazing what technology does, but at the same time, we have to catch up a little bit with that. And
yes.
When, you know, if we don't respond right away, it's not because we don't want to respond immediately to you. We are busy doing other things. It's not always the best time for us. Irv might be at a show.
Right.
You know, Dee may be in another location, you know, hiring somebody.
Yeah.
You know, so it's not that we don't want to get back to you, but please give us at least 24 hours
for sure.
of business hours to get back to you. But we certainly are interested in what you have to offer and what you have to bring to the table to the Children's Home of Reading family. But I know you had talked about possibly opening up the doors and letting people just come in for a interview off the street. You're planning on doing that too?
Again, what I love about that is, again, those collaboration, because it takes not just myself, but also there's a whole gamut of individuals that are part of this. It's not just the recruitment, but it really is about, you know, other individuals engaging in this new process, this new career path that we are now going to open the floodgates to many individuals. So it's about, you know, again, stopping and, you know, having this dialogue. And even if you don't know what jobs are available, it's okay. We can have that. We can explore together. But I think the number one key, whatever department, is about really knowing, going there, that you want to be invested. You want to be impactful. Like you said, both not only to the individuals we serve, but also to yourself too. You know, there's a
right.
connection that needs to happen. You know, I was amazed by the number of job seekers yesterday at Downtown Reading, and I got to know a lot of people. It was really great because you got to see many individuals, from those who are interested in dietary, those who are interested in, you know, social work. I was just in almost like a culture shock within my own community to realize, wow, why not continue this dialogue? Here's my information.
So, right, and that's great. And, you know, we've done focus groups before.
Right.
I've done them with the fund development side of it, as well as marketing and some of our special events that we've done. We've done them for some programs even before we started. So that's always something that's, you know, that's a great opportunity for you to have a dialogue. Maybe we have that open forum at some point to talk about the human service crisis of finding staff with all these vacancies.
And now that the summer is coming here, again, you know, our goal is to allow the kids that we serve to have a fulfillment in their day-to-day without interruption.
Right.
So there's a lot of pressure to making sure that we find those ideal candidates to fill in those vacancies, to make sure that their days are not interrupted by perhaps what we have to do or what we lack of.
So let's talk about that. We have three shifts that we do for the most part in residential.
Yes.
So that's one. That's a whole beast inside of itself.
And that's where the high demand is.
The high demand. And especially on the weekends.
For sure.
So, even for RNs.
Yeah.
You know,
right now there's a huge, huge, huge call, or I should say casting call, for RNs and youth care workers, especially on the weekends and in the second, third shift. And we have such a great leadership in that department that the flexibility that they allow to meet to meet your needs, but also work together. It's amazing. But yeah, there is a need for RNs, there is a need for youth care workers, especially in the weekends, because, you know, I don't know about you, if I have downtime, either I get in trouble or I'm doing something that I'm not supposed to, like eating too much or I'm sleeping, so it's very like, but I think really filling in those vacancies are such a high demand. And again,
and they're full and part-time positions.
Oh my gosh, there's full part-time. There's also various sign-on bonuses as well. And of course we have a great, insurance. So there's a lot of perks and exciting, you know, assessment for each of the individuals that apply.
Yeah, so we talk about the residential. We don't always talk about the clinical side. And many of our kids, as everybody knows, everybody's heard 1,000 times on the show, kids have needs. Mm-hmm. And we all are finding that there is a mental health crisis in the United States all over the world. And we're trying to address that. And unfortunately, kids are waiting longer and longer and longer, as people are, for the help that they need. So when they come to us, they're at an acute level, they need to be seen right away, and we need to be able to tell them that we have people who are here to take care of them.
For sure.
And so, you know, clinicians play a huge role in what we do in our outpatient, in our acute partial hospitalization, in our in-home services that we do. We do a lot with our PA forensic associates, our foster care, you know, and there's always a demand for clinicians as well.
And that is so key, because, you know, working with clinicians will really kind of allow us to kind of navigate what are the areas that each individual needs and how can we provide that in whatever capacity. Perhaps they have everything's connected. Perhaps this individual may have a dietary restriction. We bring in our food service staff. Perhaps this individual needs structure. We bring in the youth care worker. So again, it's those collaboration, those connections that are really going to allow us to provide a well-rounded service and programs.
Yeah, and I just want to say I'm glad that you're on campus, because you're available, you know, for the most part, Monday through Friday. Sometimes we're going to be doing things on the weekends. So
yeah.
Where would somebody go to find information, Irv?
Well, of course, you know, I gave you my phone number, but of course you can always go to our website, which is buildingkidslives.org. And, you know, for me, just learning about the 45 different, you know, programs and services was an exciting kind of self project to get into. Because, you know, again, you want to be able to allow an individual who comes in and provide them that, you know, the background, the great information, and have them make a good, well-informed decision on, is this the area for me?
Right.
Yeah.
So if you are interested in learning more about Children's Home of Reading and the careers that we have, please go to our website. It's right on there, buildingkidslives.org. At the very top, it says careers, and it lists. Sometimes it will spotlight something that's going on. It may be where we're showing up in the community, mm-hmm. like you were with Manny and,
yes.
and Eddie. Yesterday, and I think you're going to be, what, at the Iron Pigs up in Allentown,
Allentown
for some of our programs.
Yes, and then, you know, we're going to work with the Pennsylvania Career Link, not just here in Berks County, but we're expanding. So, and again, that is when we talk about community outreach. That's what we're talking about.
Right.
And learning from each other and having those connections, because certainly you have to be able to be sourcing in various, you know, areas.
And it's not just the college student that's graduating.
Right.
It's somebody who might want to make a difference mm-hmm. in a different line. They've been in the career for a while, or they're just getting back into a career. It might be a stay-at-home mom or dad that, you know, let up, or they, you know, for a variety of reasons. Or it could be that retired person who's always wanted to do something a little bit different,
right,
but doesn't want all the pressure of, you know, having to go to work every day, but
right.
they might want to do something. Or, I mean, having the flexibility, I think, is key, and opportunity. And I just think that, you know, I've been there now 7 years, so I'm invested in the fabric of the family.
Right.
You know, I think of us as a quilt. We all bring a thread together, and all those threads, you know, become the quilt that surrounds the kids that are in our care and the families. But you're now part of that. And we want to make sure that everybody has your phone number. So, Irv, would you give it to me one more time?
Sure. It's 610-478-8266. Extension 487. And I also want to bring out to you that, you know, there are individuals that have worked with CHOR before mm-hmm. that they decide, you know what, I want to come back. And to be able to have the open doors to say, welcome back, and pick up where you left off, I think that's a great key component as well.
Right. So a key candidate has to be 21 years or older.
Yes, 21
that's
years.
Because of our regulations.
Right.
That's...
And, of course, there are specific educational requirements as well as, you know, job details, which is all listed within the titles of each of the jobs. So it's very specific, but yet what I was promoting yesterday was that we have an opportunity to bring in individuals from various educational requirements or educational backgrounds, from those who may just have a high school diploma, a GED, to those who perhaps decided to go on and on and on. So there's something for everyone. Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, and I love that.
So as we start the next chapter of the Children's Home of Reading's Lives, in our it will be our 140th year next year. So I kind of think about this as the prequel. And then let's see if you can be a part of it, because we've been here a long time and we're not going anywhere. And I can't imagine Reading being without the Children's Home of Reading and the services that we have provided year after year. But really, with all those people who have helped, all those children who are now our future,
mm-hmm.
and people like you, people like me, but the next generations to come.
For sure.
So I think it's really a wonderful opportunity. If you'd like to learn more about the Children's Home of Reading, our website is buildingkidslives.org. You can also friend us on that Facebook thing, you know, if you like it and it's your thing, great. We would love for you to friend, and we always love when you share. But watch for some wonderful opportunities here of Irv having an open house. You never know. You might just see the casting call and Irv out there with his director hat. I hope you're having a great day. And thanks so much. So we are looking for the casting call for careers today at Building Kids Lives.
Building Kids' Lives in Our Community on BCTV is supported by UPMC for You.
Thank you.